everyone. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are new. I hope you will stick around and subscribe. So today's video, obviously from the title, you know it's a home update and it's a really fun one because it shows the very, very beginning stage when there was nothing on the ground. It hadn't even been excavated yet and we were just taking our like, this is our lot photo and now to what it is. It's come a long way in a very short amount of time and I'm so thankful. So what you're about to watch is a montage of all of that put together up until about last week. And then I will sit here and have a talk with you about some of the things I'm thinking of as far as like moving forward and decor and things like that. And before we get started, I do want to say this video was inspired by my girl, Kara Linnell. She is also building a house. Love, love, love Kara. This is not a collab, but I'm going to shout her channel out because she is one of my very, very best YouTube friends. So it's really cool to be going through this with her as well. And I was totally inspired by her video to make this one because I feel like it's a really good time to make this video. We're halfway done the process and I just wanted to inform you guys of, you know, everything that's gone on thus far. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Montage that I put together. I'm so proud of it and I'm so excited that we'll be able to look back on those memories as a family. And I just, like I said earlier, I'm so happy and I feel so, so blessed to be building a home right now. Brandon and I had always said that we wanted our very first home that we owned together to be a new build. And so for that dream to be realized and that to come to fruition is just, it's the best feeling. So let's get into it. Let me tell you a little bit about like the bones of our home. So this house is obviously a new build, but it is not a custom build. I want to make that very clear, meaning this overall layout of our home did not come from mine or my husband's brain. We did, however, choose our exact floor plan out of several of the builder's layout options. We picked it because it seemed like it was the best choice for what we were already looking for our family. It is exactly what we needed, and I know for a fact that we will not outgrow this house before it's time for us to move again. That said, we were also able to choose the kitchen and bathroom hardware, the countertops, the cabinets, the paint colors that you'll see when we move in, the lighting packages that they offer, and a few of the other things that we chose to upgrade to. The house itself is 3,000 square feet. It's 4 bedrooms, 3 full baths, and it has a loft. There's also a formal dining room and a separate room that will be my office. So I'm really happy to finally have a space where I can edit and I can keep my lighting equipment and film my sit down videos because these steps are not doing it for me anymore. And before you internet trolls come at me, because some of you guys already have about my house, Brandon did not want an office in this house at all. He works 6 months on the road and 6 months home, so he didn't really feel like he needed one. And so we asked, he didn't want it. There we go. So there's a couple very normal things that we're gonna have in this new house that I don't have or haven't had in a very long time since living at home with my parents. And so you guys may be like, that's so normal, why are you so excited? But I'm just really happy. And the first one is a backyard. The house that we're currently living in is a rental. It has a fenced in backyard, but there's no grass. So it's not really an ideal situation for me to have Sebastian running out back in dirt and rocks and things like that and weeds. And so now to have a yard where he and Margo, who will eventually start walking, can play and have their birthday parties in and just go outside every day, and makes my heart feel so good. Growing up, when I was young, I had a very, very large backyard and I loved running around and playing in it. So to even have a piece of that in our new house is just a blessing. And then the other thing that is very normal, but I'm excited about because we don't have that here, is a walk-in laundry room. And it's not even a huge laundry room, but I can walk in and close the door and do a few spins in it, because here we have what is called a laundry closet. So you open the two French style doors and it's just the laundry right there with a wire rack above it. And so to have a laundry room, an actual laundry room, that feels so good too. Like I said, that's not a big deal, but it just makes me happy because it's just something I've not had since I lived at home with my mom and dad. Something that I do have in this house that I really am excited about having in the next house is a loft so that the children can have a play area. I am still trying to figure out how, because it's in a loft and it's an open area so people can see it, how to make their colorful toys look cohesive in the house, because it doesn't have a closed door, it is a loft. But just for us to have a space for them to play and watch TV and do what they want that doesn't impede upon another bedroom in the house is really nice. I love that everybody will have their own space if they want it, and it doesn't take away from our guests who will also have their own space downstairs. So one of the major questions that I've been getting asked as we've done this build is, has everything that's gone on in the world caused your house progress to slow down? I've been putting updates out weekly since this started, and the answer is no. Thankfully, even though we are in the midst of a global pandemic, construction in Georgia has always been considered an essential occupation, and so they've been able to keep on schedule and continue to build our house, which is awesome, because that means the builder can continue to work, the construction workers themselves can still work and provide for their families, and obviously for us, we still can stay on schedule and move out of this house and move into the new one as we hoped. Overall, the building process has been really smooth. Right before they started building, there was a pre-construction meeting, and that was just to make sure that everyone was on the same page. And then the building started, and now our builder calls us every Friday to tell us what they've done that week and what they plan to do the following week. He also sends photos of the progress, but what's funny is the community's property manager also sends pictures, and then also our real estate agent goes by and makes sure that everyone is like on task, and she sends photos. Plus we go weekly, sometimes a couple times a week, and so we take photos, so we do not have a picture shortage for our memories in the future. Everyone is completely clued in on where we are and what's happening at all times, and I really, really love that. There's going to be another meeting next week now that the outside is pretty much built up. We have they started the insulation on the outside as well. So I don't think I put that in the montage, but I can put it right here. And that meeting will just make sure that, again, we are on the same page about everything with drywall and all the things that come along with that. Through this process, I'm seeing my husband in a whole new light. I've never seen him during a build process. All we've ever done is decorate places. We lived in an apartment before this house, and then in this house, I decorated a little bit, but I kind of stopped almost 2 years ago because I knew we were moving and I didn't want to put anything else into this house that we don't own. But it's really exciting watching my husband get super excited about the build and, you know, seeing like, you know, the actual brick and mortar of it all happen. And even though he's super excited about that, what I'm excited about again is the decorating, because that's where I feel like I'm going to shine, and it just needs a homemaker's touch. So let's get into a little bit of the design and decor aspect of it. I am by no means an interior decorator. I am just very particular about the things that I like in pretty much every aspect of my life. And I'm also a very visual person. So what's been really hard for me is I cannot purchase things for this house until I actually go in and see it. So that means the walls and the initial paint colors need to be up, the floors need to be down, and I need to see that before I can start purchasing things for the spaces. And that's been so hard because I'm so excited and I see things and I'm like, oh, I want that, but I just have to wait and be patient. And this has been a true test of patience for me, but it will be so worth it. So once the house is complete, there will be things that I call placeholders, which are the finishes that we chose that will probably be taken out and repurchased by us. They offer different packages for hardware in the kitchen and in the bathrooms and things like that, and that's great, but none of them were really what I want or go with the idea I have in my mind, and so we selected one, but I know I'm going to eventually change it, and I'm talking about hardware all the way down to the doorknobs, like everything's gonna get changed. So in the kitchen, I didn't have them add island light fixtures just because I know that I'm going to buy those elsewhere, so no need to pay for those twice. But until I can actually visually see the two-story foyer, I can't tell them don't put a light in there because I won't be able to buy one quick enough for them to put in there, and we will be without a light, if that makes sense. So I have these placeholder things going in, and then eventually over time, once we're moved in and live in it, I can start, you know, taking things out and adding things here and there. Also, after the build, and this may seem silly to some people because we're building it now, so why not do it now? But like I said, I'm a visual person. We are going to be doing some custom woodworking throughout different spaces in the house. Another thing I'm really excited about is our closet. It's not the biggest closet in the world. It's the walk-in closet, and it has a very unique shape. The standard shelf is just a wire rack around each part of the closet, and I hate wire shelving. We have it in this one, and I cannot wait to move and have an actual closet. And so we decided that after the build, we're going to hire a custom closet company to come in and really work with the space, because it is a unique shape and it has eaves. So I feel like if we do it ourselves and we're not careful, we can lose a lot of really good space in there. So we are gonna have that built out as well. And I'm really looking forward to that because it just makes me feel like an adult. I remember when my parents built their house, and so for it to be my turn now, I'm just over the moon. So as far as decor is concerned, the top question is, what is your design style? That's been the question I've been asked on my Instagram so much when I've posted the updates. And I'm not an interior designer. Like I said, I don't know all the names of different types of like home spaces. And the way I would explain my design aesthetic is cozy, contemporary, with like a sophisticated vibe. I like a lot of tone on tone. The base color of the home will be gray and taupe. It'll be very moody. And I think that you guys will see eventually that my design style is a little bit different, maybe from what's really popular right now. I do have an all white kitchen. Well, my countertops are gray, like a lighter gray granite. Brandon wanted that. I think we looked at, I don't know, at least 12 or 13 countertop slabs, and Brandon was stuck on a granite countertop, so he got that. And I chose an all white kitchen, one, because it's aesthetically pleasing, but two, because until I can get in there and do what I want with it, like I said, I have to be in the space to change it, it will at least look pretty. So an all white kitchen coming from a brown kitchen downstairs is like a dream. Over time, as we make these changes, we'll be able to enjoy our white kitchen before I probably change the island to a darker color. I also will include a lot of really plush, lush throw pillows and textures. We're gonna do grass cloth wallpapering, and there's gonna be a lot of thick and cozy blankets to warm up the space. The house will have a two-story family room, and if you're not careful, it just becomes this wide open space that doesn't feel cozy. And my goal is to bring intimacy and coziness and lush comfort to this really tall open floor plan. If it comes together like I plan, it will be beautiful. Oh, little Margot's waking up, so I gotta end this soon, but I don't think I could be more excited right now. I just feel like God has blessed us so much, and I hope that you guys are excited to take this journey with us. Thank you so much for supporting my family and loving my family, and I can't wait to bring all of the home content to you. Getting out of this house and the moving process, which I will document all of it, will bring me probably the most joy of the summer because it's been a really weird year. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.